Oh my, that's hello. Hello. Hello, so welcome to this live stream. This live stream is all about two video tutorials that I published a long time ago, but when I published it, it didn't have any audio, so it didn't have any narration. So there's a lot of requests that I put narration, so that's what I'm going to do today. So I'm going to have basically two video tutorials that I'm gonna put audio or narration. So the first one is creating a simple and easy logo, this kind of logo, and also using the envelope tool in CorelDraw. So this is like roughly around 4 minutes each video tutorials. And so later on, once I put narration, I'm gonna open it to the chat room for questions and answers. Okay, so we'll start with the creating a simple and easy to create logo. So I'm going to go to my YouTube video, and I'm just going to move it over here. And I'm just gonna maximize this, and I am going to play this. Sorry about that. Okay, so I'm going to put this here, and I am going to enlarge that. Okay, so now I'm going to play this, and then at the same time I'm going to add some narrations. Okay, so creating a simple and easy to create simple and easy or creating a simple logo. So first I'm going to, if you notice, I just deleted the text. So the first thing you have to do, or I have to do, is to type in AMG. And say, for example, that's the logo that we're going to create, make it bold. And then what I'm going to do here, I'm going to remove the fill and add a thin black outline. Remove the fill by right mouse click on that. So now it's easy for me to see the text now. So I'm going to create an ellipse so that it will intersect the letters. I'm going to go to smart fill. And as you can see, you can choose any color for your smart fill here. So I chose blue. Click on the areas that I want to fill. And then I'm going to delete the ellipse. So after deleting the ellipse, I'm going to fill the text, the uniform text. So now I'm going to remove the outline. So this one are these areas here. Those are the ones that I use the smart fill, and then I'm going to click the text on the on the top part of the logo, and I'm going to use the transparency. Click and drag downwards. So, and then after that, what I'll do, I'm going to click on the I'm going to create an ellipse first, and I'll intersect the logo, and I'm just going to skew it, and then I'm going to scale it down a little bit, and now I'm going to choose a thick outline. Let's say 4 points. Click OK, and I can also color the outline. So I'll just make the outline thicker, and then use the eyedropper tool to sample the color, and then go to that ellipse and then click. Okay, and so that's, and I'm going to move the ellipse back of all the objects. I'm just going to position that. So I think that's it. So now what I'll do, the next thing is I'm going to select the lower areas of the text. And then what I'll do, I'm going to duplicate. So plus sign your keyboard and then bring it down. Because what I'll do, I'm going to make a reflection. So I'm going to change it to gray. I'm going to click on the transparency tool and then click and drag going down. Okay, so that's a really simple logo, and it took me less than 5 minutes. Okay, and then put it to back of page, the reflection. Okay, so I'm going to close this now. And so that's the first narration, and let's go to the second one, which is using the envelope tool in CorelDraw. So I'm just going to get that, just this one here, and then I'm going to rewind this and then play. Okay, using the envelope tool in CorelDraw. So I'm gonna zoom in here. So first of all, I'm going to delete the text here. So here's my objective. See this text, creativity is contagious, pass it on. So I'm going to just create an artwork of those texts, and then what I'll do, I'm gonna group this together. So make sure to group it, because if not, you're gonna use the perspective one object at a time. So here I'm gonna go to my Bezier tool, click, and then I'm going to make that as a curve. And then another line, and then make it a curve. Same thing. Go to your shape tool and go here to the curve and shape it. So now what I'll do, I'm gonna create a line. It has to be intersecting those two lines, because what I'll do later on, I'm going to do a smart fill. Okay, so now I'm ready to go to smart fill. And I click on the center. So now I have a shape already. So I just remove the extra lines. Okay, so now I'm going to do with the other mug. So go to the shape tool, click on the line, go to convert to curves. Okay, shape it. Okay, and then the other one, so same thing. Line, and then the shape tool, and then I click on the line and then go to convert to curve and then drag it down. Okay, so I'm going to make two intersecting lines now. So go from the top to the bottom and another one top to bottom. The same as the first mug, I'm gonna put a smart fill and delete the other lines, delete the extra lines. Okay, so now we established already the shape of the mugs. Now I'm gonna go to this banner stand, so I have to create a shape so that we can apply perspective to that. So I'm just gonna make a perspective rectangle, and that's it. So I've got three shapes now to for our reference. So I'm gonna select that, okay, and then after selecting I have to resize it a little bit so that I know, and then I'm going to duplicate this three times because I'm going to use it for the mugs and the banner stand. So I choose the first one that I duplicated, and then make sure to group it first, and then go to your envelope and then click on the shape and then click apply. So same thing here, you click on create form and then click on the form, and that's it. And then the only thing you have to do is, oh yeah, for this one too, you have to click on this, which is envelope, and because we already created the shapes. So the only thing to do is to delete this lines and shape and just put the graphics on. So that's a really so envelope is really useful, especially in creating mock-up, you know, artwork or mock-up products for your clients so that they can approve it. And that's it. So I'm going to close this now, and yeah, so for the people in the chat room, so welcome. And that was just a short one, because I wanted to do this so that because I've been requested to put audio in it. So anyway, that's it. So any questions about the tutorial? Any questions? Oh, hi, Chris. Yeah, thank you very much. Do you have any question, Chris? Yesterday you said you wanted a word art tutorial. I'm working on that one. I just have to think about what sample I would do, but that's coming up. Okay, so if you don't have any questions, I would, it's just gonna be a really short live streaming, and I will create another one tomorrow, the last one for this week, and then I can do the next one will be on Sunday. So I will, oh hi Susie's here. Yeah, so I, you didn't miss anything. I just, these were just my old tutorials without audio, and then I just added some narration. It's kind of strange because I just have to put narration on the non non-narrated videos. But yeah, so it's today's gonna be short. I didn't prepare anything actually. I just want to add narration to these two videos. Anyway, I think that's it for today, and thank you for attending, and I will see you tomorrow. Yeah, so it's coming the same time tomorrow, which is Thursday, Chris, and I'm just gonna do a day off for live streaming on Friday and Saturday, and hopefully I can do one on Sunday, but I'm gonna try to do it regularly. Yeah, so but same time, 12:30 my time. Okay, so thank you very much, and I will see you tomorrow.